Hi, my name is Chuba Klets. This is 16th video in which we are going to look at IS41 agriculture. So let's start. The objective of IS41 is to establish standards of accounting for agricultural activity. Agricultural activity refers to the transformation of biological assets, living animals and plants, into agricultural produce, harvested products. So, scope of IS41. IS41 applies to biological assets, a living animal or plant, all except bare plants, agricultural produce at the point of harvest. Agricultural produce is a harvested product from biological assets, a government grant related to biological assets. IAS-41 doesn't apply to bearer plants, intangible assets related to agricultural activity. This one is regulated by IAS-38, land related to agricultural activity. This one is regulated by IAS-16. What are bearer plants? Bearer plant is a living plant which is used in the production or supply of agricultural produce. It is expected to bear fruit for more than one period, has a remote likelihood of being sold as agricultural produce except for incidental scrap sales. So an example of a bearer plant can be an apple tree. Let's go to the next slide. Measurement of biological assets. Biological assets should be measured at fair value, less estimated costs to sell, both at initial recognition as well as upon subsequent measurement. The gain on initial recognition and subsequent changes in fair value should be included in profit or loss. If the fair value cannot be measured reliably, the asset is measured at cost, less accumulated depreciation and impairment losses. Once the fair value becomes measurable, an entity must switch to fair value treatment. Measurement of agricultural produce. Agricultural produce should be measured at fair value less estimated selling costs at the point of harvest. The gain on initial recognition is taken to profit or loss. Agricultural produce immediately becomes inventory. That is why there are no rules regarding subsequent measurement. Agricultural produce must always be measured at fair value. Let's go to the next slide. Government grants. IS41 also applies to government grants. However, for that to be the case, corresponding biological assets must be measured at fair value. If the biological assets are measured at cost less accumulated depreciation, government grants should be treated as per IAS-20. Under IAS-41, unconditional grants should be reported as income when they become receivable. Conditional grants should only be reported as income when all conditions have been met. So let's look at several examples. Imagine a sheep that is kept to produce wool. The sheep is a biological asset and is in the scope of IAS-41. At the time of shearing, the wool is agricultural produce and again comes within the scope of IAS-41. Once sheared, the wool becomes part of inventory and outside the scope of IAS-41. In terms of measurement, the sheep at the point of birth is recognized at fair value list costs to sell, the gain goes to profit or loss. As the sheep grows, its fair value continues to change with corresponding gains and losses being recognized in profit or loss. At the point of shearing, the fair value of wool is measured and the gain is taken to profit or loss. So, let's look at another example. Imagine sugar beet, a plant harvested to extract sugar. The plant is biological asset and comes within the scope of IAS 41. At the time of harvesting, the meat is agricultural produce and again comes within the scope of IAS 41. Once harvested, the meat becomes part of inventory and is outside the scope of IAS 41. And the last example, our entity Fluffy Kitten purchased 2,000 dairy cows on January 10th, 2018. Average age of cows is 3 years. The cost of cows is $2 million. Please explain how this should be treated in the financial statements. There is next data about fair value of dairy cows. So we have a table here and we can see that 3-year-old cows have fair value of $1,000 at the beginning of the year and $1,100 at the end of the year. And 4-year-old cows have a fair value of $1,200 at the beginning of the year and $1,300 at the end of the year. So let's look through example. The dairy cows must be initially recognized at $2 million, which is a purchase price. In this case, also fair value in an active market lists purchase costs. The cows must be measured at fair value. They are biological assets and are in the scope of IAS 41. At the end of the year, cows became 4 years old. I'm sorry for a typo here. My apologies for this one. That's a typo. Here should be 4 years. I'm sorry for this one. So, at the beginning of the year, we have a 3 years old cows, which means that at the end of the year, cows became 4 years old, and hence must be measured at fair value of $1,300. Let's look at the table again. So, at the beginning of the year, we purchased cows on January 10th, January 2018. They were 3 years old. But a year later, at the end of 2018, they became 4-year-old cows. That's why we should use this fair value at the end of the year, $1,300, which means that we should take 2,000 cows, multiply them by fair value of $1,300, which gives us $2,600,000. So, in the notes to the accounts, we can include also disclosure of change in fair value. There could be also two types of changes. One due to prices change and another one due to physical change. So let's look again at the table. As you can see, the price of 3-year-old cows increased from 1,000 at the beginning of the year, the fair value of dairy cows increased, 3 years old dairy cows increased from $1,000 to $1,100. That's a change due to price change. That's price here. And the change due to physical condition is this one. Because at the beginning of the year we have 3-year-old cows, and at the end of the year 4-year-old cows, which means that we should measure not, we should use not this one fair value, but this, because they are 4-year-old. So this one is a change due to physical condition. Physical This one is due to physical condition. So let's look at the calculation. We have 2,000 cows. We have price change for from 1000 to 1100, which gives us an increase of $200,000. And also, change due to physical condition, again, 2000 cows, and increase from $1,100 to $1,300. That's a fair value for 4-year-old cows, which gives us $400,000. And if we sum up these two to check, we have 600,000 dollars. $600,000. I'm writing here million. 0.6 million. And as you can see, that's in line. At the beginning of the year, we have $2 million fair value. At the end of the year, is 2.6 million dollars. The increase was $600,000. So, and as you can see, we can explain that the change is due to prices have increased by $200,000, and another is due to physical change, increase of $400,000, which gives us our total increase. So here we have checked that our calculation is correct. Here we have change of 0.6 million to As you can see, they are equal, which means that our calculation was correct. So, that's the end of our review of IAS 41. Thank you for watching. Continue to learn, continue to read more articles, continue to practice to level up your knowledge, and don't give up. Again, thank you very much for watching, and I hope that I'll prepare new videos soon. Bye.